Say to them, I'm glad.
You're sitting beside me.
Because I'm anointed.
For your deliverance.
For your testimony.
For your answers.
And for your access.
But also for your acceleration.
I'm glad.
You're sitting beside me.
Because this anointing I'm feeling.
It's too much.
It's too strong.
I'm glad.
You will benefit
from this anointing.
If you know
who you're sitting beside,
right now,
you will give me
some prophet's offering.
Because I'm anointed
for your intervention.
If you know
that you're sitting beside
a strong anointing,
you'll give me a high five.
See, they were quick to give you a high five.
But when you ask for the prophet's offering, they didn't even shake their backs.
Can you imagine that?
Amen.
I'm truly excited you're here today. And I'm really a kiss in the spirit.
Praise God.
Please, as soon as the man of God comes in, just Minister Tina. Minister Tina, please, once you see him, just bring him. Amen. But Shola was supposed to pick him up. He was supposed to come up here at about 8:15. But all things work together for good.
Amen.
Please, turn off the AC. I don't think the people say they are hot. Amen. So just turn off the AC. Very quickly, I think we are 5 minutes away from here. While we wait for him, it's not going to take long. Tomorrow will be a blast. But because I promised you guys I want us to close early today. I want us to close early. Amen?
Amen.
And so early can be anything around 10 or 10:15. Okay?
Amen.
This is revival service.
Amen.
I don't know if you believe this is revival.
Amen.
Amen. So, and I especially celebrate every one of you, especially those of you that drove more than 5 minutes away to be in church. Amen.
Amen.
Because I tell you, okay, Jerry, Pastor Jeremiah, sit down and listen to me. Okay, that's my son. Okay. So I celebrate your life and I thank God for your life.
Amen.
Let me give you guys something very quick before the man of God comes up. Isaiah chapter 41. Isaiah chapter 41 from verse 15. We'll read 15 to verse 20. Everyone read, one to go. Behold, I will make thee a new sharp threshing instrument, having teeth. Thou shalt thresh the mountains and beat them small, and shall make the hills a shelf. Before you go to the next verse, go back to that verse 15. I want you to take note of something here. Most of us miss answers, access, and acceleration because we are busy waiting for God to do things for us. As much as God wants to do things for us, can I tell you?
Yes, sir.
God wants to make you the doer of things.
Amen.
The day you come to the place where you settle in your heart and say, Lord, what I really want you to do in my life is to make me the doer of things rather than the waiter for things. When Jesus showed up, a lot of people doubted him. But when he attended a wedding, the Bible says, this is the beginning of miracles that he did and manifested forth his glory. So he was carrying something inside of him. But that thing needed to be seen and known by others. The only way they could see, or the only way they saw that glory, was when he did something. I want you to know that as much as God delights in doing things for us, his greatest pleasure is when he does things through us.
Amen.
Amen to God.
Are you listening?
Yeah.
The greatest pleasure of God. Listen, this is the same God that said, let there be light. And there was light. When he wanted to destroy the earth, what stopped him from saying, let there be dark? Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
What stopped him from saying, let there be dark? If he had said, let there be ark, there would have been ark.
True,
false.
True.
He needed to build a tabernacle. And he said to Moses, you're going to build me this tabernacle. Take gold and silver from the people. Tell them to bring the gold and the silver that you will use in building their ark. Now, do you know what thrilled me the most about that? As you read in Hebrew, the writer of Hebrew quoted the words of God to Moses. He said, see that thou build according to the pattern that was revealed to you on the mountain. As you read deeper, you find out that the pattern revealed to Moses was the pattern in heaven. The temple was already, the tabernacle was already built in heaven. So God gave Moses access to heavenly treasures. And when Moses saw what he saw, God said, go back and duplicate it on earth.
Wow. Yes. Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Why did God say, tabernacle, appear? Oh, for your information, he can do it.
Yeah.
And he's still gonna do it.
Yeah.
Read the book of Revelation. Because the Bible says, and I saw heaven open. And I saw what? A new Jerusalem descending from heaven. So God wants you to know that if you wanted to build Jerusalem, if you wanted to drop it on earth, he would drop it. And as the chapter of the earth closes, he's going to drop already made city. So if you can drop a city from heaven, why have you not been dropping all these things from me?
Come on now.
Because has deposited himself in you. And one of the characteristics of God is that God is a creator.
Amen.
If you have kids and you've watched your kids, or you have siblings, or when you were a child, you build certain things with Lego. How many of you know Lego? How many of you ever played with Lego? How many of you ever got applauded for building something by your parents? If your parents didn't do that, I need to lay hands on them. Go and call them, I'll lay hands on them. And if you are a parent, you've not applauded your child. If you have not bought Lego, go and buy one.
Yes.
And for some of you that have children that are already adults, go and buy one and and give them the pleasure of revisiting that child with this. Because you watch your children build something. And as they are building, maybe building a house, you show them a picture and they build. As they are building, they might misplace certain things. You watch them and you show them, no, put this here, put this here, put this here. How many of you have had any kid, any child that say, I did it? How many of you have had such? Oh, if you have not, I can call my daughter here. And have her do something. And you will hear, Daddy, I did it. Give me a high five, high five, high five. I did it. God delights in you and I creating things while he watch us. He likes to watch you create. And if in the process of creation you make a mistake, he helps you and he adjusts the thing. Do you know that when you become a creator, you become a celebrity? In order for God to do that, in order for you to become a creator, God said, I will make you. Not I will make things. Go back to that verse. Verse 15. He didn't say I will make things. He said I will make you. I am more interested in making you than in making things. Because I know if I make you, you will make things. Are you still listening?
Yes.
I want you to open your spirit. The Lord said to me, he said, this is a unique season. Number one, say unique.
Unique.
If you are wise and you've not written it, you have to write it. Number two, he said, this is a strategic season.
Yes.
Say strategic.
Strategic.
Number three, he said, this is a divine season.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
What is the meaning of divine? Divine means God's own. So this is God's own season. Are you with me?
Wow.
Number four, he said, this is a fertile season. Say fertile. So I told you, I said, this is women are known to go through, mature women are known to go through certain cycle once every month. Before the menstruation, there is a cycle of ovulation. Ovulation comes to give the woman the opportunity to create a life. If she misses that opportunity, the cycle goes on and then translates into blood.
Lord.
that you end up losing. So every time you lose the season of ovulation, you begin to experience menstruation. Oh, I'm coming at you. Are you with me? The only reason you have menstruation is because the season of ovulation was not maximized.
Amen.
Are you with me?
Yes.
But ovulation is an evidence that God wants you to God wants you to create life at least once every month. Now you can keep missing ovulations and ovulations and ovulations, and you are having menstruations and menstruations and menstruations. And one day you will wake up and the feeling is no longer the feeling of ovulation. It's not an accident that God allowed. When a woman is ovulating, that's when her hormones are high and she's more honey. Okay, stop that, man of God. Because all is about to spiritual. So, because there ought to be something that desires a seed. Because now you are fertile, ready to create life. But you keep missing it. And if you miss it, and miss it, guess what happened? One day you wake up. The feeling will no longer be a feeling of pleasure and attractiveness. It will now be a feeling of pressure and irritation. So when it is a season or a feeling of pressure and irritation, it is called menopause.
Amen.
It's God talking to you. Let's celebrate the man of God. Come on.
Oh my.
So I'm bringing up the fact. Is it interesting?
Yes.
So by the time you keep missing, you miss the season of ovulation, and you experience menstruation. Menstruation is proof of wasted opportunity. You understand? Now you know that once you become pregnant, you no longer menstruate. Because it shows that you have taken advantage of your season. But at least once every month, you have an opportunity to create a life and a destiny. So God said, if you don't take advantage of the season, you come to a place where it is called menopause. It means it is P-A-U-S-E. It is now us. The reason why many people are not serious with their lives is because they think that they have a lifetime to make their destiny happen. Honey, I want you to know you don't have a lifetime to make your destiny happen. If you don't wake up and take advantage of this fertile season where the Holy Ghost is moving all over and
I release an edge. There is a spam of the Holy Ghost all across the body of Christ today, and is looking for that ovulated womb to put something, to make sure you become pregnant and create something. I want to prophesy to you that this generation will hear of you. This generation will celebrate you. This season you will be honored. This season you will be celebrated. And that which you will carry will be holy. That which you will carry will come forth. Now somebody shout, it's my better season.
He says, number one, it's a unique season. Number two, it's a strategic season. Number three, it's a divine season. And number four, it's a fertile season. Every seed you sow, the season is fertile. Are you with me? This is the time you sow a seed and you will reap in 24 hours. This is the time you pray. And before you are done praying, you already have the answers. Yeah. Are you with me?
Yes,
sir. I said, this is number five. This is a prophetic season. Yes. It's a prophetic season.
Okay.
When it's a prophetic season, by a prophet, the Lord brought Israel out of Egypt. By prophet, he preserved them. Prophetic season is always a season of intervention. So there is nothing that escapes the prophetic oil. Number six, he said, this is a fruitful season. And number seven, he said, this is your season. Say, this is my season. Say, this is my season. So let's read that verse again. Let's read that. It says, behold, verse 15, I will make thee anew. So what am I trying to do? I want to make you. Because if I make you, you will make things.
Amen.
I will make you a new sharp threshing instrument, having teeth, and then thou shalt thresh. Not God will thresh. I will give you the ability to destroy the mountains that resisted your fathers and the mountains that have been resisting you. And he said, as far as the hills, you will turn them into chaff. And then verse 16, it says, thou shalt fan them, and the wind shall carry them away. So when you do your own side, you see God doing his own path. He said, and the wild wind shall scatter them, and thou shalt rejoice in the Lord, and shall glory in the Holy One of Israel. Why am I doing all of this? Verse 18, loud and clear. Everybody wants to go. I will open rivers in high places and fountains in the midst of the valley. I will make the wilderness a pool of water and the dry
springs.
Somebody shall
access.
I will open rivers. That means I will give you access. I'm preparing you so that you can maximize the access that I'm about to give to you. There are seven things I wrote down that God will give you access to.
Thank you, Lord.
But it's my joy and my pleasure to bring up here the man of God.
Yes.
Tomorrow will be hot and hot. This night, let's receive prophet, doctor, jumbo, my are hearing, can you make some noise?
This is kind of good. You're giving praise, worshiping, giving praise. Go ahead and give him praise. Go ahead and give him praise. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. Jesus, in name we pray.
Amen.
See that for a while. Who is the mother of this child? Amen. Tell somebody, no shaking.
No shaking.
If you don't mind, stand up, move to as fast as you can. No shaking. No shaking. No shaking. Move from your seat, tell somebody, no shaking. Shout hallelujah. What you don't know is bigger than you. What you don't know is what? It's bigger than you. If you refuse to handle your issue, you will become an issue. If you refuse to handle your issue, you will become an issue. Life is not turn by turn. Life is God, give me my own. Life is not turn by turn, but life is God,
give me my own.
The cure of life is very long. If life is turn by turn, your turn will not come. There are people who are more intelligent. There are people who are more influential. Before it will get to your turn, you are a dead person. I prophesy over your life. Your worst days are over. The worst days of your life is over. I declare over your family. I declare over your home. I declare over your head. Your worst days is over. Let me hear seven of amen. Was right down. Before I left the hotel, man of God, the Lord spoke to me. This prophecy is for this church.
Yes.
This prophecy is for this church. Write it down. It will not be too long from now. This church will produce multi-billionaire. On Sunday, I'll be speaking on the subject, I will meet with favor. I will meet with favor. In life, you must meet with something. In life, you must meet with something. In this world, also, everyone is a carrier. Depend on what you are carrying. Some carry AIDS, some carry cancer, but I carry favor.
I carry favor.
I don't know about you, I carry favor. I decree over your life. That favor that will take you to another level. Receive it in the name of Jesus. teaching that. What is faith? Favor, I define favor just like that. Just like that. You got that job. Just like that. Your documents are approved.
Just like that.
I decree over your head. That favor, receive it in the name of Jesus. The number two thing the Lord spoke to me in this night before I left my hotel. I said to my brother, my friend, I said, tomorrow I'm going to do a lot of things. He said, no, please, sir, please come. He's my boss. So if the boss says you should call, you have no choice than to obey. I have to come. But the Lord said to me that every member of this church, none of you will die young. None of you. As long you are in this garden of life, there is a divine coverage. If people die earlier in your family, God will use you to correct it. Let me get a better amen. None of us will die young. None of us. As far as you are in this church, I'm saying to you, no shake. God will put testimony in your mouth. And the testimony will last for a very long time. Stand to your feet. Billionaire, God is raising there. Life is not by faith. Life is by favor. Life is not by faith. Life is by favor. I was almost tempted to start, but let me control myself. I was almost tempted to start. If I start now, I'm going to move on. But let me control myself. I pray for you this night. I pray for you this night. Whatever that will make you to suffer again, whatever that will make you to suffer again. By this your amen, it is canceled. Yeah. One prayer before I leave you, Father, shorten the days of my agony and increase the days of my joy. Shorten the days of my agony and increase the days of my joy. Shorten the days of my agony. And increase the days of my joy. Shorten the days of my agony. And increase the days of my joy. Shorten the days of my agony. And increase the days of my joy. Clap your hands and pray that prayer. Clap your hands and pray that prayer. Open your mouth and pray that prayer. Amen. Let me hear the loudest amen. Hear me as I leave you tonight. The worst thing that can happen to a man is to arrive late. the worst thing that can happen to a man is to arrive late. Late hour blessing is not good. Acceleration gives you quick blessing. What others achieve for 20 years without divine acceleration, you can achieve it for 6 months. I prophesy to you. I prophesy to you. As many who are ahead of you, Jesus. As many who are ahead of you, in the next 3 months, you will be overtaken. In the next, you will be 10 times brighter. From the crown of your head down to the sole of your feet, be free from sickness, be healed in your body, be healed in your spirit, be healed in your pocket, be healed in your bank account. In the name of Jesus. Father, I prophesy to you, America will favor you, Chicago will favor you, anywhere you enter, it will favor you, even Jesus. It is well with you, my dear. It is well with you, my dear. It is well with you, my dear.
Amen.
I decree one more time. Every evil program into your life, every disaster ahead of you, every pain ahead of you, by this your amen, I blow it away. By this your amen, I blow it away. By this your heaven, I blow it away. By this your heaven, I blow it away. Every problem that came suddenly into your life, came suddenly into your marriage, came suddenly into your head, I decree now, suddenly may it disappear. Suddenly may it disappear. In the name of Jesus. Go in peace. Your case is settled. 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 In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. Come on, give it praise, give it praise, give it praise. Father God, let me do this before I leave. Let me do this before I leave. Because if I move it to tomorrow, something might happen. Something might happen, but we want to correct something now. Sir, you have to pray for this young man that is doing this. We have to pray for him. Pull your covers, please. Tomorrow, don't go and train. Are you with me? Don't go for training tomorrow. I'm seeing you train tomorrow for something on Saturday. I'm seeing you train tomorrow for something on Saturday. Let me tell you now. If you go training tomorrow, you will have injury that will make you not go on Saturday.
What's happening on Saturday?
City Championship.
Do you have training tomorrow?
Yes, sir.
Don't have training tomorrow. The training is, we are going to do the training now. We are going to do the training straight away.
Yeah.
All
Amen.
I have to do is the training.
Yeah. Amen.
I want to give it to you. Amen. Because this thing determines your next level.
Yes.
This thing on Saturday, it determines your next level. Favor is not fair. Can I shock you? The husband you call your husband today is not your husband before. It was somebody's boyfriend. Your wife, you cherish now. Sweetheart, honey, all the stuff. Somehow, someone used to call her. Sweetheart, honey, and all that. But somehow, you work for them. It works for them. Favor is not fair.
Amen.
I said, favor is just. No man can expect success, nobody. Forget book, seven keys to something. There is no key to something. It is just. There is no key to success. Hold that your stock is going to be a you don't need to change it tomorrow because something else will have happened. That will have deprived you not to show up on Saturday. Man, which of you is more anointed? Which one you I'm seeing all kinds of oil there. So, stand to your feet, sir. Lord, you reveal to redeem.
Yes.
Every revelation is unto deliverance.
Yes.
Lord, I want to anoint the leg of your son. Let the angels take over his leg.
Yes.
Let the hosts of heaven take over his life.
Amen.
Let no man see him. Let everyone see your glory.
Yes.
And I'll let you start with this all.
Amen.
Go and do exploit.
Amen.
Go and do exploit.
Amen.
In the name of God the Father,
Amen.
God the Son,
Amen.
And God the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Your training is over.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Congratulations. Come on, give him praise, give him praise, give him praise.
Okay, amen, amen, amen. Well, tomorrow, Reverend Shola, by 7:30, you're at the hotel.
Okay, I got it.
7:30. Tomorrow will be fire for fire.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Now, you want to come quickly. So, that's okay. Tell me, what were you supposed to do tomorrow?
Tomorrow, I was supposed to have practice on Saturday.
What's happening on Saturday?
City Championships.
Oh, so you went to his hotel and told him that?
No, sir.
So what happened?
It was revealed to him.
City Championship. Now, it is yours already.
Amen.
So, champion Emmanuel. My beloved, I don't want to overdo this thing, but I'm telling you, my spirit man is on fire.
Amen.
And I know if we allow him to go on now, I had a brisket here at the back, it will be on. So whatever you have to do to be here tomorrow. Tomorrow is Friday. It's not night vigil. It's going to be at 7 p.m. By 7:45, 7:50, you should start ministering. The prophetic is very time consuming. So we don't want him to start and then 1 hour, oh, there's no more time. No, there'll be time. So you'll have at least 2 hours to share God's word. Oh, he said maybe 2.5 hours. Amen. Amen. But God will move here tomorrow.
Amen.
I want to lift up your hands and say, Father,
Father,
locate me.
Locate me.
By your word.
By your word.
And your power.
And your power.
Walk in my life.
Walk in my life.
The kind of work.
That
only God can work.
Oh,
has He granted me access to unlimited resources? I receive divine acceleration. I give you praise. And I give you glory. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and just pray. Tell Him to locate you. Tell Him to locate you. Locate you. Move in my life as never. Shibata go break the chains. Zekete so break the chains. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty
name.
Amen. Say to your neighbor,
this is
my fertile season.
My
I'm ovulating
spiritually.
I have received
seed.
Right now,
the
seed of the word
is resting
upon my life.
My womb
has received. So look out for me. The word says,
in 3 months.
God's servant said,
in 3 months.
And I believe,
just as
it has been reconfirmed that Martha Pilonias will rise from this ministry. God will use this ministry to raise Martha Pilonias. I register myself as one of the confirmed Martha Pilonias in the name of Jesus.
This generation
will celebrate my life in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
And very quickly, we're going to close. I'm not going to even try to push this further. I'm not going to try to come and give you the 7 things you should have access to. We're going to receive our offerings. Now, hold on. Before you even do your offering, hold on. I went somewhere. I had a very important meeting. God has been moving mightily. Are you with me? You're tired. God has been moving mightily. And I am also a major partaker of everything God is doing. I received a call. Someone very, very strategic and important. I didn't receive the call. He said he has been looking for my number. And finally, we were able to talk. And I went and I held a meeting in today. All the way somewhere called Lincolnshire. And when I finished the meeting, I got into my car. I started screaming. Aka Akaya! Aka Jehovah Nebema! I sang several songs. Because when God walks certain works in your life, you have too many songs to sing. And as I was driving out, I saw the street I was driving into. The name of the street is a major street. The name is Akpatiski. Is probably someone's name. It's difficult to pronounce, but because of the impact of that individual. A street was named, not just a street, an entire drive was named after him. You think your name is hard to pronounce? Wait until you succeed.
Amen.
Because when you succeed, people will think that the best name to be named, even if your name is Abluku Bakaka. There was a governor we used to have in these states, Governor Goglaivish. Even you don't know how to pronounce it. You think I'm the only one that don't know how to pronounce it? But whether I know how to pronounce it or not, because he was the governor, if you go for an interview and they ask you who is the governor of the state of Illinois, as at that time, you will have to learn that name and pronounce that name. What am I trying to say to you? God spoke to me, and I shared it with you before, that most of you will have not just streets, not just roads, not just drives, but highways.
Yeah.
Towns,
yeah.
Cities,
yeah.
States,
yeah.
Made after you.
Yeah.
Only the people will say. When you become your divine prophecy, even your enemies begin to look for how to take advantage of your principles.
Amen.
Stop running about speaking and worrying yourself about what people think or say.
Amen.
The best way to answer your enemies is to succeed.
Amen.
The only key to silencing insults is to have results. They may deny your existence, but they cannot deny your results. In conclusion, Jesus said, if you don't believe me for who I say I am, believe me for the very works that you see me do. I'm speaking to you today. You may appear to be a nobody. That's why I want you. Don't make stupid decisions. Choose your friends. If you are not married, you are very lucky or favored. Christians don't get luck, they are favored. Don't get married based on where you are. Get married based on where you are going to. Because if you get married based on where you are now, you have already implicated yourself by being a part of this ministry. You have implicated yourself to succeed. So right now, success is the only choice you have.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you will become what we have been prophesying into your life.
Amen.
So when you become a multi-millionaire, and unfortunately, you have settled with somebody who has a peasant mindset, you don't have a tribe, you are telling her, honey, God just revealed to me that I'm the one to invent the airplane the man of God has been talking about. The airplane that we pack in space. And then she said, okay, I'm not trying to stop you. I'm not trying to stop you, but be careful. Because her mind cannot conceive what God has revealed to you.
You will be very big.
Amen.
No, you didn't hear that.
Amen.
You will be very big.
Amen.
You didn't hear that.
Amen.
You will be very big.
Amen.
Church on Fire International. The time comes and it's not too far. Where the janitor, a janitor in this ministry, will be making more money than a medical doctor.
Amen.
Where this church, each Sunday, we will be nothing less than 200,000 people attending service. Where we will take over that 10,000 acres of land that God gave to us.
Amen.
Where we will build God a city.
Amen.
It will be called the Billionaire City.
Amen.
Where your housemate will own her own house in your compound. With swimming pools.
Amen.
Your housemate. Do you know that, sir, Bill Gates' housemate is making more money than many PhD holders?
Amen.
You don't know that? Bill Gates' housemate. Can you see you? I know most of you say, no, I don't like all this materialistic preaching.
I love it.
I told you, if you are not materialistic, you are not like God. You are preparing to go to heaven. God, his own street driveway is paved with gold. Which billionaire can pave their driveway with gold? Except you and I.
No,
listen, I will do it practically. We will replicate the streets of heaven on earth. We will glue the gold to the ground. At least even if it is one street.
Amen.
The one that leads to the house. So you will walk on gold. So that when you get to heaven, you will not be. We will do it.
Amen. Amen. Praise God.
So, where material things become annoying is when material things own you. When your success owns you, then you are a disaster waiting to happen. But when you own your success, just like Church on Fire International, we will set aside money. We will make sure other churches own their properties. We will give scholarship. So all those pastors that are trying to fight us, they don't know God. Or they know God, but they know. Are you following me? Because if you know God, you will know that He wants His kingdom to spread. How can we do it? When we assist each other. You remember yesterday's message, right? He said, I will block your right eye.
Right.
Then, as a reproach. But I told you, I said, number one, He's not going to block our right eyes because God has given us answers. Nahash. But number two, in case your whole right eye has been blocked out, and you have left eye, don't worry. Come to the other person that has left eye too. When you bring two left eyes together, one becomes right, the other becomes left.
That's right.
So the things you could not accomplish with your left eye, I add my right eye to your left eye. We both become two eyes. And then we surprise the enemy.
Yeah.
Are you listening? I want you to know what I'm doing is
is a mandate. It's an anointing. A bishop asked me, he said, how can you be able to pay 1 million pastors? Some of them will just use you. And the Lord gave me a ready answer. And I said to him, the only time you know that a meat is missing in your soup is when you don't have enough meat.
That's right. That's right.
If you don't have enough meat in the pot of soup, 3 is missing, you will notice it. But when you have pokoto, shaki, outfit, ariagotoko, all they are sorted in it. So I said to him, the Lord said, whoever wants to take advantage can take advantage. After all, God Himself, the creator of the universe, is being taken advantage of by atheists who say there is no God, yet He causes His sun to shine upon them. He causes His rain to come upon them. The people that have no respect for Him, He still gives them rain and sun. Why? Because He is an inexhaustible source. My older sister, who is a product of my prophetic ministry, she's so blessed. People named her Dr. Betty alias See Never Dry. Most of the time, the minimum she carries in her bag and move around has changed. It's 1 million naira.
I will receive it.
Are you listening? Yeah. Receive it, take it. And not now that this, I mean those days that even the naira was very strong. She never tried. Believe you me, there are some things I say that people think, how are you going to do this kind of thing? Why will you say, instead of you using money to buy houses for yourself and do this, you say you want to buy churches for others?
Right.
No man can receive this except it be given to him from above.
Amen.
It's my calling.
Amen.
It's my mandate.
Yes.
It is my mantle. Is what I was born to do. This is who I am. You may struggle to be generous. I don't struggle to be generous. Generosity is in my blood. I was born to make people great. I got a text from my son last week. Dad, I've been trying to reach you. When I was training that young man, I told him, why? And they called him pastor's boy. Take your night vigil, you do this, you do that. All of those things. Now that's it, my son. He's a pilot, specialized pilot. He flies billionaires. But do you know if the reason why he flies billionaires in their private jets? Because that's his prophecy. He's just flying them for a season. Because very soon they will be flying him around.
Amen.
I was born. Christ to make people great. The prophetic oil on this place, you know, is not the one that prophesy and till thy kingdom come before it comes to pass. No, it always manifests.
That's right.
And that's one of the things I thank God for. This man of God.
Yes.
Tomorrow, next tomorrow, raise yourself up. Don't be anointed to come late. Rebuke that demon. I know this house is going to be back tomorrow. Remember, it's Friday. We hear God will move your life.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I'm happy. I'm excited. And I'm fulfilled. Because the you I'm seeing today, you will become the same mortal billionaire that God has called this ministry to raise.
Amen.
If you receive it, raise your hand and say, I receive it.
I receive it.
Let's close.